Hello, Grade 8! Sa video na ito, ang atin namang i-discuss ay addition and subtraction of dissimilar rational algebraic expression. Sa pag-add at pag-subtract ng mga dissimilar rational algebraic expression, ay mayroon tayong method na ginagamit. At ito nga ay ang butterfly method. So, ipapakita ko sa inyo kung paano natin ina-apply ang butterfly method. So, meron ako ditong halimbawa na 1/5 plus 3/4. So, ang ating munang example dito ay mga rational number. So, wala pa tayo mga variables. Ang una step na ating gagawin ay mag-drawing ng wings ng ating butterfly. Ayan. So, kung makikita nyo, mayroon tayo ditong 1 and 4 na nasa loob ng isang wing. And other wing naman, ang nasa loob niya is 3 and 5. So, later, ang gagawin natin sa dalawang pares na to ay i-multiply. So, after nating i-multiply ang dalawang pares na to, ang susunod naman doon ay i-multiply ang mga denominator. So, kapag minultiply natin ang ating denominator, magkakaroon tayo ng body ng ating butterfly. So, dito natin isusulat ang ating magiging sagot. Okay, so i-perform na natin. So, as you can see here, we will just perform the cross multiplication. So, first, let's identify the product of 1 and 4. Okay, so 1 times 4, that is equal to 4. So, yung product natin ay ating isusulat sa antena ng butterfly. Again, 1 times 4 is 4. So, here is our product. Next, we will have 3 times 5, that is equal to 15. So, ito naman ang product ng 3 and 15. So, after that, we will now proceed with the multiplication of the denominator. So, 5 times 4, that is equal to 20. So, sinulat natin ang 20 sa body ng butterfly. So, na-perform na natin ang butterfly method. So, ang mga nakuha nating number is 4, 15, and 20. Ayan. So, next, this will be equal to, for our numerator, we will just copy yung answer natin kanina na 4 and 15. So, our operation here is addition since that is the given operation. And for the denominator, we just copy 20. Alright, so we can now simplify this. 4 plus 15, that is equal to 19. Over 20. So, we just copy the denominator. Therefore, 1 over 5 plus 3/4, that is 19 over 20. So, ayan, solve na natin ang ating sum ng rational numbers using butterfly method. Ayan, so alam na natin ang process ng butterfly method. So ngayon ay i-apply na natin siya sa pag-add or pag-subtract ng mga dissimilar rational algebraic expression. So para sa ating first example, meron tayo ditong addition of dissimilar rational algebraic expression. So hindi na natin i-drawing ang butterfly dito sa pag-add ng dissimilar rational algebraic expression. So ang gagawin na lang natin is sundan yung process na ginawa natin kanina. Okay, so let's proceed. So we will have first our numerator. So for the numerator, we will just perform the cross multiplication. So isulat muna natin yung ating mga imu-multiply. So, first, we will multiply 5 by 2x plus 6. So, isulat muna natin 5 times the quantity of 2x plus 6. Okay. So, nilagay natin sa parenthesis ang 2x plus 6 dahil itong dalawa ay imumultiply natin mamaya sa 5. Okay. Next, so we will just copy our operation plus and we will do the other wing. So, that will be 4x times the quantity of x plus 5. Ayan. So, again, sa numerator, we just do the cross multiplication. And for the denominator, so tulad ng halimbawa natin kanina, imultiply natin ang dalawang denominators. Okay. So, this is the product of x plus 5 and 2x plus 6. So, inilagay lang natin silang dalawa sa loob ng parentheses. Okay, let's have our next step. So, after we perform the butterfly method, we will now simplify our numerator. Okay, so yung denominator natin, pwedeng hindi na natin to i-multiply sa example na to. So, kakopy na lang natin to mamaya. Okay, so to simplify the numerator, we have to do here the distributive property. Okay, so ano ba yung distributive property? So, meron tayong 5 outside the parentheses dito sa ating unang addend. So, yung 5 na nasa labas ng parentheses ay i-distribute natin inside our parentheses. Okay? So, pag nag-distribute, our operation is multiplication. Okay, so let's answer. We will have 5 times 2x, that is equal to 10x. Next is 5 times 6, that is equal to positive 30. Ayan, so ginamit natin ang distributive property para makuha ang product ng 5 and 2x plus 6. So, let's do the same sa 4x times the quantity of x plus 5. Okay, so we will distribute 4x to x and to positive 5. So, let's multiply. So, this is positive 4x because we will use the addition sign as sign of 4x. So, this is positive 4x. Okay, so 4x times x, that is equal to positive 4x squared. So, iduduktong natin siya dito sa 10x plus 30. And last, we will have 4x times 5. So, that is equal to positive 20x. Okay, so na-simplify na natin ang numerator. So, again, we'll just copy the denominator. Yan. So, kinapi lang natin, pero ito pwede silang i-multiply using FOIL method. Okay, next step. Ayan. So, if you observe our numerator here, makikita natin na meron pang mga terms na pwedeng i-combine. Okay, so we will look for the like terms on the numerator. So, those are 10x and positive 20x. Okay, so itong dalawa lang ang pwede nating i-combine sa numerator dahil sila yung may parehas na variable. So, sila yung mga like terms. So, yung 30 tsaka 4x squared, walang pwedeng i-combine sa kanila. So, kokopihin lang natin sila sa numerator. Okay, so dito muna tayo, identify natin ang 10x plus 20x. So, that is equal to 30x. Alright, so we just do the combine like terms. Again, wala na tayong pwedeng i-combine sa 30 at 4x squared. So, isusulat lang natin sila dito sa numerator. Okay, then we will copy again our denominator. Okay, so as you can see here, ang numerator ay nakasimplify na. So, for our final answer, so pwedeng ito na ang ating sagot or pwede nating ayusin ang ating numerator in descending order. Okay? So, we will write first 4x squared. So, ang mauuna nating isulat is yung term with highest exponent. Okay? So, our exponent here is 2. So, this is the leading term. Followed by 30x plus 30. So, sinundan siya ng term na may variable with 1 as your exponent, that is 30x, and lastly is our constant. Okay, so this will be our final answer. So, we just copy the denominator. Let's have another example. We have 7 over 3 minus 8 over 12x minus 8. So, we still have here the similar rational algebraic expression. So, we can use the butterfly method. So, let's start. So, we will have 7 times 12x minus 8. Okay, so itong dalawa yung ating minultiply. Next, that will be followed by minus 8. So, we just copy here the subtraction symbol. So, that will be our operation times 3. So, kapag okay na tayo sa numerator, we will have our denominator. So, we will just multiply the two denominators. So, let's write here 3 times 12x minus 8. Okay, so after that, ano ang ating next step? So, tulad ng example 1, ang ating sunod na step dito is to do the distributive property. Okay, so here we will have 7 times the quantity of 12x minus 8. So, here we just do the normal multiplication. Okay, so since ang nasa loob naman niya is a number or a constant. So, diretso lang natin itong multiply. Okay, so balik tayo dito. So, we will have 7 times 12x, that is equal to 84x. Next, we will have 7 times negative 8, that is negative 56. Okay, so be careful of the sign. So, the subtraction symbol here will be the sign of 8. So, that will be 7 times negative 8. Again, the answer for that is negative 56. And here, we will have negative 8 times 3, which is equal to negative 24. Alright, and for our denominator, let's just copy that here. We will have 3 times the quantity of 12x minus 8. Okay, let's proceed with our next step. So, next step is to combine like terms. So, pag tinignan natin ang numerator natin dito, ang like terms na pwede nating i-combine is negative 56 minus 24. Okay, so we will just bring down 84x. So, let's solve for negative 56 minus 24. So, the answer for that is negative 80. Okay, so kung nalito kung paano nakuha yung negative 80, so since we have here subtraction of integers, we can do the keep change rule. So, we will change our operation to addition and positive 24 will become negative 24. So, we now have negative 56 plus negative 24. So, babalik tayo sa rule ng addition. So, we have same sign. So, pareha silang negative. Kaya, inad natin ang 56 at 24 at yon ay 80. And next, para malaman kung anong sign ng 80, so, tingnan din natin yung kanilang sign. So, pareha silang negative. That's why we just copy that on our answer. Okay? So, again, negative 56 minus 24 is negative 80. Okay. So, tulad ng ating first example, pwedeng ito na ang ating sagot. Yan. So, ang ating denominator ay hindi pa natin namu-multiply yung 2 or yung 3 at ang 12x minus 8. So, we will have another answer here, okay, wherein we will distribute 3 inside our parentheses, okay? So, if you multiply 3 by 12x minus 8, so that will be equal to 36x minus 24. So, ang ginawa natin dito is just use the distributive property. Okay, so this is our answer on example number 2. 84x minus 80 over 36x minus 24. Ayan, so ito na ang ating pangatlong example. So meron tayo ditong addition ng the similar rational algebraic expression. So we have 3 over b minus 5 plus 6 over 3b minus 8. Okay, so using the butterfly method, so cross-multiply muna tayo for our numerator. So, we will have 3 times 3b minus 8. Okay, so nilagay natin sa parenthesis ang binomial na 3b minus 8. Next, we will have plus 6 times the quantity of b minus 5. So, dito galing yon sa numerator ng pangalawa at denominator ng unang given. Next, for our denominator, so we will just have the product of the denominators. So that is the quantity of b minus 5 times the quantity of 3b minus 8. Okay, so next, let's simplify the numerator first by using the distributive property. Alright, so we will distribute 3 inside the parentheses and 6. We will distribute that or multiply that by 5, by b, sorry, and negative 5. Okay, so let's do the multiplication. So first, we have 3 times 3b. The answer is 9b. Next, 3 times negative 8. The product is negative 24. So let's proceed with the second addends, which are 6 times b minus 5. So 6 times b is 6b, and 6 times negative 5 is negative 30. Okay, so this is our numerator, and for our denominator, we just copy that on our solution. Okay, yung first process na ating ginawa. Okay, let's proceed. Yan. So, to get the final answer, we will just combine like terms. So, sa numerator natin, ang mga like terms ay 9b at positive 6b. Okay, so 9b plus 6b, the answer is 15b. Okay, so naiwan ng negative 24 at yung negative 30. So, pwede ba natin silang i-combine? Yes, because they are both a constant. So, we can combine negative 24 and negative 30. Okay, so that will be negative 24 minus 30. So, the answer is negative 54. Okay, so ginamitan din natin siya ng KCC. So, magiging negative 24 plus negative 30. Okay, so that is negative 54. And let's just copy again our denominator. Alright, so this is our answer on 3 over b minus 5 plus 6 over 3b minus 8. So let's now have our last example. So we have here subtraction of the similar rational algebraic expression. So our given is 4 over x plus 1 minus 2 over x plus 2. Okay, so let's perform or use the butterfly method. Okay, therefore, for our numerator, we will have the product of 4 and x plus 2. So we will write here 4 times the quantity of x plus 2. Okay, and next, we will have 2 times the quantity of x plus 2. So take note, our operation is subtraction. So we will have here minus 2 times the quantity of x plus 1. Okay, so for our denominator, we will just multiply the two denominators. So we will have the quantity of x plus 1 times the quantity of x plus 2. Okay, so let's proceed to our next step. We will use what property for the numerator? So that is the distributive property. Okay, so we will multiply 4 by x and positive 2. And next, we will have negative 2 times x and negative 2 times 1. Okay, so dito muna tayo sa unang given. Okay, so we will have 4 times x is 4x. Next is 4 times 2 is positive 8. Okay, next, so take note of our sign. So this is negative 2 times x. So that is equal to negative 2x, and negative 2 times positive 1 is negative 2. Alright, so we will just copy our denominator. So let's simplify again our numerator. So we will combine like terms. So we will combine 4x and negative 2x. And later, we will have 8 minus 2. Okay, so 4x minus 2x, that is equal to 2x. And 8 minus 2, that is equal to positive 6. Okay, next, we will just copy our denominator. Okay, the quantity of x plus 1 times the quantity of x plus 2. So this is our final answer on example number 4. We have 2x plus 4 over the quantity of x plus 1 times the quantity of x plus 2. Ayan, so para mas maunawaan mo ang ating lesson sa video na ito, ay maaari mong i-replay at balikan ang ating mga examples. Thanks for watching!